Hello friends, welcome to GT Science tutorial. In this video, I'm going to explain about vibrational energy and zero point energy. We know that in a molecule, there are three types of energy level: rotational energy level, vibrational energy level, and electronic energy level. In my previous video, I have already explained about rotational energy level. You can find the link in the description below. In this video, we need to talk about the vibrational energy level. We will see its formula and then we will talk about zero point energy. So let's start. We know that vibrational spectra arises due to the transition between the different vibrational energy levels, and the spacing between the vibrational energy levels is larger than the spacing between the rotational energy level. So more amount of energy has to be supplied to get the vibrational spectra. One more thing, rotational energy was calculated by considering the molecule to be rigid rotor, that means they cannot rotate. In the same way, vibrational energy is calculated by considering the molecule as a harmonic oscillator. Okay, so vibrational energy is calculated by considering the molecule to be a harmonic oscillator. Simply means they vibrate perpendicularly. Okay, they vibrate perpendicularly like this. Now by using this condition, we get a formula for the energy of vibrational spectra or vibrational level. Okay, that formula is therefore EV means vibrational energy is equal to h nu naught v plus 1/2. So this is the formula for the vibrational energy. Let's consider to be equation number A. Okay, here this nu naught is fundamental vibrational frequency. We know that if the molecule vibrate, it must have certain frequency. We have considered it to be nu naught v means vibrational, that is this v. Okay, this v vibrational quantum number, and this h means, you all know that, Planck's constant. So this is the formula by which we can calculate the energy of vibrational level. You can see over here, if we put the value of V to be 1, as V is the quantum number, that is V can be equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, just like rotational quantum number. We denoted rotational quantum number by J, we denote vibrational quantum number by V. Its value, it starts from 0 and it keeps on increasing with different vibrational energy level. Now when V is equal to 0, if V is equal to 0, then what do we get? E0 is equal to h nu naught 0 plus 1/2. It simply means h nu naught by 2. If V is equal to 1, then we get E1 is equal to h nu naught 1 plus 1/2. If we add it, we will get how much? 3/2 h nu naught. In the same way, if we consider V is equal to 2, then we will get E2 is equal to 5/2 h nu naught. You can easily calculate by putting the value of V is equal to 2 over here. You will get this much. Now, in the same way, this value keeps on increasing as we increase the value of V, right? Now we need to see one more thing. A very interesting thing is observed over here. Like, see the value when we put V is equal to 0, then V is equal to 1, V is equal to 2. Okay, it has the spacing of h nu naught, that means e1 minus e0. If we subtract e1 minus e0, if we do e1 minus e0, how much do we get? 3 by 2 h nu naught minus 1 by 2 h nu naught. So it will simply be how much? 3 by 2 minus 1 by 2 h nu naught. This is a like fraction, so we can simply subtract it like this. H nu naught, it is equal to h nu naught. In the same way, if we calculate e2 minus e1, if we subtract e1 from e2, if we do e2 minus e1, then also we will get how much? H nu naught. If we do e3 minus e2, we will get h nu naught. That means del e will always be, del v e will always be how much? H nu naught. That means the spacing of the vibrational energy level will always be equal to how much? H nu naught. It is constant. Okay. Now, this was for vibrational energy. You need to remember this formula. This formula is very important. Okay. Now, we need to see what is zero point energy. You can see two formulas on the board. The first formula is for vibrational energy level, and the second formula is for rotational energy level. If you don't know how this formula came, then you can check in the description below. You can find a video. Just watch that video. You will definitely know how this formula came. Okay. Now, we need to talk about zero point energy. Zero point energy means simply saying what will be the energy at absolute zero of temperature. Absolute zero means the lowest possible temperature, that is zero Kelvin, right? Zero Kelvin. Now, at that temperature, the value of rotational quantum number and vibrational quantum number will be zero. So let's see what happens mathematically. Okay. Now, at absolute zero, here also let's write the same thing. At absolute zero, V will be equal to zero. Here J will be equal to zero. Then it will be E is equal to H nu naught 0 plus 1 by 2. That means in place of V, we need to write 0. So it will be H nu naught by 2. Right? We get this much of value. And here if we put J is equal to 0, then how much will we get? H square by 8 pi square I into 0. On 0 plus 1. So this 0 will make all the values 0. That means EJ will be equal to 0 and EV will be equal to this much. What do you see from here? What do you see from here? What is the conclusion of getting this much of value? That means at absolute 0, there won't be any rotational energy in the molecule. That means the molecule cannot rotate. But here we are getting certain value. That means even at absolute zero, the molecule is not at complete rest. It will not rotate. Yeah, that is true. But it will vibrate in perpendicular axis. Okay. Even at absolute zero, molecules vibrate because they possess certain vibrational energy even at absolute zero of temperature. So the energy, this much of energy, okay, this much of energy is assigned at absolute zero of temperature as well. So the energy, let's write it, the vibrational energy at absolute zero is called zero point energy. So this is the value for that zero point energy. Okay. This is the value for that zero point energy. Let me repeat one more time. At absolute zero, there is no rotational energy in the molecule. That's why EJ becomes zero. That means it cannot rotate now. But even at absolute zero, there will be certain vibrational energy. That means this much of value H nu naught by 2 That means even at absolute zero, they vibrate. So all the molecules will always vibrate even at absolute zero of temperature. This formula tells that. So this is the value for zero point energy, and this is the definition for zero point energy. I hope you understood everything about vibrational energy and zero point energy. That's all in this video. If you like the video, please share this video as much as you can. Thank you for watching the video.